Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. How are you all? So today we have a new video, and as you can see, after a really long time I got ready because I wanted to dive into makeup. I was craving to dive into makeup, and I tried to match my eyeshadow with literally my top. So yeah, that's how it is. Now today's video is all about hair color, and I would say if you are into hair color, if you would like to get your hair colored ever in your life, I would say do not skip this video. This video is extremely useful for people who are going to have hair color, if they've ever had or they are going to have it. So I would say please do watch it. Now when I was getting my hair colored, I wish somebody would have made such kind of video to actually tell you something about hair coloring. But of course nobody really told me. This is something I am learning from my own experience, and I want people to know this too before they regret like I did. So without wasting time any further, let's just get into the video. Now before jumping in, make sure you subscribe to my channel if you like me or you like my videos, and press the bell icon to get notified whenever I post a video. Also follow me on social media. All the details and links are given in the channel art. Press them, you will get redirected, and just follow me everywhere. You know, I'll just start up with my story of hair coloring. Now I got my hair colored twice. If you can see there is some portion of highlighted hair over here, and if you can see there is some portion highlighted over here. This, the ones that were in my tip, can you see this particular strand of golden color? This is the highlight I got in previous year, June 2017. And this I got done from Faridabad. And this particular portion of my hair, if you have seen in the video, it's like over here near my scalp. This particular portion, I got it in this February 2018. Now the difference between these two colors is, this is something I bought from Faridabad, and you know, these were like 18 strands of highlights in my hair. Of course I got my hair cut, and it was literally like more than 1.5 years ago, almost like 1.5 years ago. So of course most of the color has really faded away. The 18 strands actually costed for rupees approximately 3,600. You know, there was like 200 for each strand, and this particular one was rupees 100 for one strand. So I got 5 strands done that costed 500 rupees to me. The main thing is, there is extreme difference between these two colors. When I got this particular thing done, of course I was not very sure if it's going to suit me or not, so I went on the safer side and just got my tips done. There was nothing on the roots. This particular portion was black as usual, and this was what had all these golden highlights, and it looked very pretty. Honestly, I loved it. So because this turned out to be so good, I thought let's just get this thing done too. Of course this one was much cheaper than this one. Now the story is, this particular portion that I got colored, and you know, my hair went a little dry when I got it first colored, and what I did was I just took a handful of Dove conditioner, kept it for like 10 to 15 minutes, and my hair was back to life. It was good, and you know, it's not rough even now. I think I love this particular hair. But this particular hair that had the cheaper color turned out to be really rough. You know, when I look at this particular portion of my hair, it still feels so rough to touch, and I really think if I would have got the same color I got hair over hair, my hair would have been much better. But the moral of the story is that sometimes quality is much more important than whatever affordable you are getting. Now of course this cheaper color, what it did was it dried out my hair. It made my hair so bad, I really got my hair cut. You know, can you see my hair is so much shorter now? I got it chopped because this hair made my entire hair look so bad. It was so rough, so fluffy, weird, wavy. I mean, I really hate my hair that way. I am a hair obsessed person. To me, if my hair does not look good, my life does not look good. So this particular part of my hair, you know, made my entire hair look so awful, and that really depressed me. Hair color might sound temporary, highlights might sound temporary, but the fact is when it is there, it is sort of permanent, and you don't want to look like a joker for a year or two, right? It may fade away, but the thing is it will be there for a while. So I would say, if you think there is so much risk factor involved and you are not sure if this thing is going to work for you, go for the safer thing. Rather than going for a rose gold color and you know might not work for you, I would say rather go for a blonde highlight or a caramel highlight that you know will not look that bad. If what if the color goes wrong? What if you got your hair almost rose gold over here and then suddenly you realize, no, this does not suit me, this really does not look good. Understand this thing, this is something that cannot be reversed. If you feel, okay, I'll do this and then I'll get it black again, that is not the way. When you get hair color all over again, that burns your hair and your hair is going to get even more bad. So understand this fact that there is nothing that can be reversed. Now of course hair color looks pretty and all, but of course there are some sort of damages, disadvantages that it might bring to into your hair, and I just want you to quickly understand what after effects you can get. Number one, you might get a lot of dryness. Dryness, of course, when you get your hair colored, it does take out much nutrients, much moisture from your hair, leaving your hair very dry and dull. And if you feel this kind of dryness is happening to your hair, I would say the most easy, affordable, and the best thing you can do is just take a Dove conditioner and, you know, just take a huge quantity, put it in your hair and let it sit there for like 10-15 minutes. I assure you, it's going to make your hair look much better. If you are having a dry hair problem, even if you have real life, without the hair color, you can still try this. Along with dryness, it might bring out much roughness, which you might try to take out with a conditioner, and to some extent it might come out, but just like it happened in my case, it did not. I tried every conditioner but it never happened, so I had to get my hair chopped. That was the last thing I could have done. And, another thing that I want you to know about hair color, I got my hair color, this particular portion, of course that was a much cheaper hair color, and along with this roughness and whatever it brought to my hair, another thing that happened to my scalp was this hair infection. And trust me with this, it was a really bad infection. I literally itched my scalp whole day and night. This itching was so bad, I really had to use 2 bottles of medicated shampoo literally 2 to 3 times a week to bring everything down. So do understand this thing, when you put some really cheap products that are not so good on your scalp, that does affect your scalp too. Along with your hair, your head, your scalp is also getting affected. Do understand this one thing, sometimes you need to prefer quality over money. Now let's quickly take a look into the important things that you need to remember when you are going to get your hair color. First of all, of course, go to a person you extremely trust. Now another thing, these one that I got from Faridabad, I got this done from a lady I know over like literally 10 years. I know her when she was of my age and now she has 2 kids, so of course I have some sort of trust over her, because I know she has some decent customers that have been going to her for like over years, and I'm one of them. I know this lady has some talent, this lady is good. The ones I got this done was a fresher, an amateur I would say, so of course she was not much professional in this, she did not have much experience. So there's another thing, don't go for someone you are trying for the first time. Going to a trusted person always helps. Again, number 2, go for something you know is safer for you. Don't go for like extreme bold colors that you are not sure of for the very first time. Try to go for safer colors first. When you are sure that this thing works for you, try the other thing. Number 3, when you are getting your hair color, do make sure the color the person is using on you is a good quality product. I would say ask the person what color you are using. Do try to find on Google if this is a good quality product or not. Do try to check customer feedback on various sites. You can try various sites like Amazon, Nykaa, whatsoever, and do try to find out some information about the product that is being used on you. Or always remember, your hair is much important than money, right? You might save a few hundred rupees on your color, but if your hair gets damaged, if your scalp gets damaged, the amount of money you would have to put for this thing to bring that natural thing back, to, you know, make it fine, would almost cost the same, or sometimes it would even increase. So rather than thinking about your money, think about the assets you have, your scalp and your hair. Number 5 is always make sure that the person you are getting hair color from puts some hair mask or something like that. That is an important step. Always ask for that, and that does not cost anything. That is for free. So please do ask for that. And sometimes even the person says come for spas and all. If you want to have that kind of thing, you can definitely go for that. Please remember, don't overdo it. Don't go for like color after color after color in a very short period of time. That damages your hair a lot. So always remember, there is a certain quantity of color you can put over a hair. You cannot get your hair highlighted color once after another, one after another. That is only going to damage your hair. So please think about your hair first than all these things. So guys, I hope this video actually solved much of your queries. And of course, if you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And I'll meet you in the next video. Bye bye.